Hey, so it's almost time for a new month, April, and I think we can all agree now that times are weird, so who knows what April will bring. Definitely some spring weather, I hope that would be really nice. For April, I decided to switch my bullet journal system up again. For the last like 2 3 months, I've been using this DingBats notebook, which is actually a really nice one. I love the cover, paper quality is great, so definitely recommend it. But I kind of noticed that after doing like 2 or 3 A5 journals, I got kind of annoyed with the whole A5 size. Like, on the one hand, I like it because it gives you a lot of space. So, for example, if we look at the current week that we're in, I have plenty of space to write all my to-dos and stuff. But on the other hand, it's big, it's bulky, it's not that ideal. So, I kind of felt like moving back to an A6-sized bullet journal. And I saw a lot of videos lately from people that have like these ring-bound planners or journals. So not just a regular one like this one, but one that actually has rings on the inside. And yeah, I got kind of inspired by it because I think the benefit of it is that you can move things around. If you mess things up, you can easily remove a page. So I was thinking that could be really interesting. So obviously, I'm switching to A6 for April. I got this one from AliExpress and I did make a little unboxing haul video, so I will make sure to link it so you can watch that first if you haven't. But yeah, I got this one from AliExpress. It's like a felt cover, which is actually really nice. I love the whole like look and feel of it. It's like a dark gray, almost black. And it fits A6 sized papers in it. And I bought a bunch of these like things that you can put in it. So I had like grid paper, but also some that were pre-designed for like a month or a day of the week, just to kind of play around with it. And I actually saw when I was looking for inspiration, I saw that a lot of people sell inserts for this, like printables and stuff on Etsy. So maybe eventually I will also buy some of those. But for now, I just want to try it out. And I did make setup, so it's not just April that I'm gonna show you, but like the whole setup that I have currently, yeah, in my A6 journal. Obviously, it's gonna change. I mean, I still need to figure out what I want, what I need. Maybe I'll buy some of those printables because they look really cool. But for now, I'm keeping it simple. And that's also like the layout that I wanted to have. Just keep it simple, kind of match with like the dark gray black cover, so you will see a lot of grays and black and white as well. Yeah, I'm just gonna see how it grows. But for now, I'm pretty happy with this setup. It's very minimal, and I wanted to film this video so I can actually start filling in stuff. So that's why I'm doing it right now. So my first page is this 2020 page, and what I try to do is kind of make like little sections. And maybe I'll buy these like tabs that you can buy, so you can put it on the end of the paper. But for now, I'm just keeping it like this. And one of the things that I noticed with the paper that I got from AliExpress is that it's quite thin. So this is just a one page. You can see it has a little bit of ghosting, nothing that major or bad, but it's quite thin. So I did stick together some pages to make it a little bit thicker. Also to make it like a natural, yeah, how do you call it? A boundary, I guess, between sections. So that's a little tip that I would definitely suggest you do. I wanted to start with just like a yearly overview, I guess. And then I can write down like the special events or holidays or birthdays, which I will probably do after this video. Like I said, I wanted to keep it simple, so I used just a black pen, a dark gray melt liner, and yeah, just keep it simple for now. I used the grid paper because I kind of prefer it over the dotted paper, but yeah, dotted paper is also nice. I kind of like the feeling of the grid paper, so why not? So I did the whole year, so this is 2020. So I will also write down some stuff for like January and February, although it's already been. But I do try to put this in every bullet journal or like planner that I have, so I know for next year when people's birthday in like January or February. So that's kind of the first section that I have. Then the second one is of course for April. I wasn't really sure what kind of theme I wanted to do for April, but I was thinking probably go back to what I do like a lot, which is like, yeah, kind of like brown craft paper, and then some of these stickers that I had that look really nice. And I also wanted to use some yellow because yellow is like one of my favorite colors to use. I don't use that much color, but this is like I can deal with yellow. So this is a yellow mild liner as well. This is one of those pages that I actually ordered with my cover. So this is a monthly overview, and I do like this because then I don't have to draw all the boxes, so that's great. I'm not sure if I will use everything on here because there's like something on the left which I'm not too sure about what I can use it for. And of course there's a little bit too much space because it has to fit every month, even if it has like more weeks. Yeah, I think it looks good. And what I did is, so I have this like calendar overview, which I like to have because I know then when like every day or when which specific day falls in the month. But I also like to have a list. So this is a list of all the days of the month with like the day of the week behind it, because of course this is really small. So what I usually do is I write down like small bits and pieces here. I put in some nice stickers or something like that just to make it look cute. And then this is the actual list where I would write down like appointments and stuff like that. So I kind of like to have both because it can sort of try out what I prefer most. So I just decided to do the same thing again. Then I have this little planner section for April, and I wasn't too sure what to call it because it's like my daily to-do list, whatever, I don't know. And I've been sort of playing around with this setup because I just wasn't really sure how I want to do like my to-do list and stuff. But for now I'm thinking maybe this is a nice thing to try. And the idea behind this is that on the left, so on this section and also on this section, I can do a little bit of like time planning. Like time boxing, stuff like that. And then I can use the right side for my actual to-do list. So that's the plan for now. But I only did the first couple of days just to see if it works. And for the weekend, I don't need this whole time thing, so I just put it like this. But I only did like the first week just to see if this works. If it doesn't, then maybe I will move to something like this. But then also for the weekday, so you only have your to-dos. Or what I could also do is just still have one page per day, but then set it up a little differently. But I saw a lot of different ways of doing this, so there's definitely a lot of inspiration there that I could use. So for now I only did the first week, and then if I like the setup I will use this one, but if I want to try something else, that's also fine. I mean, I just started with this, so why not. Then I have a section called diary, and the reason why I wanted to have this is because I thought it would be fun to do like daily reflections. So these are the pages that I also got in that like planner, or like in my AliExpress order. And I did change them up a little bit because this said, I think, week something, and this is like the days of the week are all like predefined, but I didn't really like the look of it. So what I did is I wrote in a piece of like grid craft paper, and then cut it out and put it on the pages because I think it looks really cute. So I did it for the whole month already, so I can simply just, you know, use this for the whole month. Not too sure if I will actually enjoy this, but I thought it would be fun to try. So I can sort of reflect on each day of the month. So if we then flip it over, this is the last week. Again, I put some pages together to make it a little bit thicker, so it's sort of sections of this piece. And then that's basically it for April. Maybe I will add some more things like on the go, but for now I think this is okay. So then we have the spreads that are sort of, will always stay in the back, I think. One is about finances. I really like to track my spending. So what I did is the following. I made a page for the fixed in and out, how do you say it, costs or income or spending, however you want to call it. Anything that I know that I will have to pay every month, and everything that I know that I will receive every month. I had it in my previous journal as well, but that one is a bit outdated because I was a good girl and I went through all my fixed stuff and tried to cancel as much as possible. So I'll make a new list so I know like how much I will surely get and how much I will surely have to spend. And then I can just sort of play around with whatever else comes in or goes out. And then of course for each month I want to also track my spending. So this is for April spending, and this is also one of those things that I got with my order. It's kind of weird, like the wording is a little weird, but then again it's AliExpress, so but I think I can make it work because it's very similar to what I had now. Pretty much I can write down the day, where I spent my money on. Then you can say whether it's cash or card. In my case, it's like 99.9% card. And then income and outlay. And I guess with income and outlay, they literally mean in and out. So that's okay. I can definitely make this work. And this I like because I used to make these things and then I didn't know how much space I would need. But now I can simply just put in another page if I have to. So that's great. And then I decided to also already make it for May and also for June. So I'm sort of set for the next couple of months. So that's gonna be interesting. And then all the way in the back, I have my like general list. I didn't really know how to call it, but I guess it's just lists. And this is stuff, just like stuff that I want to track. And it's not really linked to a specific month or a specific week. I just want to track all of this. So in my case, that's series to watch and books to read. And I will migrate some of the stuff from my old journal because I still have a lot of books that I want to read but haven't read yet. And of course, some video IDs. I have a Dutch web blog, so I have some blog IDs here as well. I should probably also do like an Instagram IDs, but I haven't for now. And then the last page would be my wish list, which I can fill up easily. And then all the way in the back, I have my notes, because I was thinking it would be nice to also have just some blank pages that I could just use on the go. So that's what's in here. These things are stickers, by the way, from AliExpress as well. They're still one of my favorites and I'm almost running out. So I think after this video, I will order some more. But yeah, I did really like the look of it, like how you can sort of section the pieces off. But yeah, that's basically it. So it's not that much yet. It's also, you can also see that it's not that thick yet, but I think it will fill up over time. And I'm watching so many videos on YouTube of like other people that have this type of system and have this like super bulky planner. So I'm like, maybe it will grow, maybe it will grow. But yeah, for now I think I'm all set for April. Of course, it's a matter of like just trying out, seeing if it works well. Maybe I'll change it around, of course, but yeah, let's see. And so far I feel really comfortable about this new setup and I think it's gonna be great. So yeah, let's see. Thank you for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any great tips for this kind of system, just let me know, because I'm happy to hear about it. And if not, then hopefully I will see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.